Hey guys, what's up? I'm Brett, and welcome back to Math Hacks. So a few weeks ago, I demonstrated for you, through a proof by contradiction, that the square root of 2 is irrational. And the proof that I showed you is the classic proof that you would find at the beginning of a real analysis course. Today, I have a special treat for you, because I am going to show you a lesser known proof, but a really awesome proof of the same result. Now, what makes this proof so awesome is that it is a geometric proof, which means that it is, for a large part, a proof by pictures, and who doesn't love pictures? Let's get started. The square root to irrationality proof I'm showing you today is accredited to Stanley Tennenbaum, an American mathematician from the 1950s. And the proof begins a lot like our classic proof I showed you before. We're still going to have a proof by contradiction, and we're still going to begin by stating that the square root of 2 is rational. This implies that we could set the square root of 2 equal to a ratio of two integers. So that is the second step. Just like in our classic proof, we're going to go ahead and simplify down this statement. Our result here is similar to the result we had in our previous proof. We have that p squared is equal to 2q squared. And instead of taking an algebraic look at this statement, we are going to take a geometric approach. So what this means geometrically is that I have a p by p integer square whose area is equal to two smaller q by q integer squares put together. So what I'm going to do next is just make a little diagram to represent these squares, and from there we could take a look at how their areas are related. So here I have two q by q squares set equal to one larger p by p square. And we know from our assumption up here that p and q are integers, positive integers, so all of these squares have positive lengths. Our next step is to assume that this p by p square is the smallest such integer by integer square we can make. This is similar to the assumption we made in our previous proof about the smallest integers that we could reduce. If you saw that proof, you'll know what I'm talking about. So I'm going to write down this assumption because this is a critical step to proving our contradiction. What I'm going to do next is take these two smaller q by q squares and place them inside of our larger p by p square, and it will result in an overlapping area. Now what we have here is our two smaller q by q squares laid inside of our larger p by p square. And as you can see, we get an overlapping area here in the middle, and we get two gaps where the squares don't overlap our original p by p square. So because we know that the area of these two squares equals the area of the larger square, now I can say that the area of where they overlap must be equal to the area that is left uncovered from our original square. All right, now here is where our contradiction is going to come in. So because we know that p and q are integers, then I know that the length of my lightly shaded square must also be an integer by integer square because it is the difference of the p length minus the q length, and both p and q are integers, and I know that an integer minus an integer yields an integer. And since I know that these two lightly shaded squares are integer by integer lengths, I can now deduce that the darkly shaded square is also an integer by integer, because if I look at these areas here, I see that the side length of the dark square can be found by taking the entire length, p, which is an integer, and subtracting out a side length of this lightly colored square here and the side length of this lightly colored square here. And we just deduced that those were integers as well. So we have an integer minus an integer. So that means that this square too is an integer by integer square. This, of course, contradicts our assumption up here that our p by p square was the smallest such integer by integer square we could make of that type. So now that we have found our contradiction, we can assume that our original assumption was false, and then state that square root 2 must be irrational. So final step is just to write that out in words, and that is what I'm going to do to conclude this proof. So I concluded by just writing out that both the darkly shaded square and the lightly shaded squares have integer side lengths, and this contradicts the assumption that the p by p square was the smallest such integer by integer square of its size we could make. Therefore, square root 2 must be irrational. So I'm curious, which proof did you like better? Do you like Tennenbaum's geometric proof of square root 2 irrationality? Or do you prefer the proof I showed you a couple weeks ago using the classic proof by contradiction approach? Let me know in the comments below. I'm really curious to find out. And as always, there are two super easy things you can do to support the Math Hacks channel and keep more tutorials like this coming your way. One, click that subscribe button if you haven't already and join the Math Hacks community. And two, give this video a big thumbs up to recommend it. Till next time, I'm Brett Berry, and thank you for joining me.